Hi there. I'm really excited to tell you about this brand new solver that is going to ship with the new release of CasADi. The solver is a development by the KU Leuven Robotics Group, and it's Lander, Vanroye, and Wilm who developed this new solver called Fatrop. Let's contrast it with IPOPT. So on the left of this figure, you have the IPOPT solver. And here are the iterates that are performed for a specific nonlinear optimal control problem formulated in CasADi that I will show later. And IPOPT is a very trustworthy workhorse in CasADi. It's very robust. You can give it a lot of initial guesses and it will often converge. It will be forgiven of small numerical requirements, and it's a very robust solver. So it's nice to have. A downside of IPOPT is that it is quite slow. It's not the fastest. So this particular problem is solved in 40 milliseconds. And you also see the part of CasADi in this. So NLP Hessian and Jacobian are dominant. So these are helper functions constructed by CasADi to supply IPOPT with the needed derivatives such that it can construct a KKT matrix. So for IPOPT, the computation time is dominated by not the CasADi functions, so they sum up to 4 or something, while the total time is 40, so the remainder is spent in mumps, or in MA57, or in whatever sparse factorization library you're using. And IPOPT is really meant for generic sparsity. So whatever sparsity pattern you supply to it, it does its job and it will solve the problem. But this generosity comes at a cost or a lost opportunity, because in fact many problems solved in CasADi have to do with optimal control, and they naturally have this repeated band structure, which is shown here on the middle. Typically you have multiple shooting, you have gap closing constraints, like here, so xk plus 1 equals ax plus b u. And these red and blue blocks, they really define this structure. And then you have this diagonal sparsity here, which is coming from the xk plus 1 term. And then typically you also have constraints, path constraints or point constraints, and they can be grouped under the green or the yellow contributions here. So if you have a structure that looks like this, there is an opportunity to exploit this. And this new kit on the block, Fatrop Solver, it does really an excellent job at performing this. So the idea is that the globalization and the general idea of IPOPT is copied. So you see the exact same iterates are happening, left to right, but the factorization is just a lot faster. As you can see in this example, we reach a total time of a bit more than 1 millisecond versus the 40 milliseconds, which is quite nice. Also note that the CasADi part, so the Hessian and the Jacobian part, so the algorithmic differentiation is a bit faster, so we went from milliseconds to microseconds. This is due to code generation, so this is just a demonstration. Because on the left-hand side, typically IPOPT or MUMS factorization time dominates, and it's not worthwhile to code generate. On the other hand, on the right, it is worthwhile, because the solver itself is a lot faster, so it pays off to make your function evaluations even faster with CodeGen. So it exploits all the block structure. So let's get started on a small example and show you how we go from start to end. Let me open up the example, and maybe I have to undo a bit of stuff. So please bear with me for a second, or a couple of seconds. Right, okay. This is not a tutorial on CasADi itself, so there are many videos that are more tutorial-ish. Here I will glance over it more quickly. This will be optimal control with a particular nonlinear system, which is a bicycle model. So it's an ODE. It has state position, X and Y, and then an angle. And then the controls are steering angle and a velocity. The ODE is given here. In MATLAB, it's a bit nicer to read without the vert cut. Then we discretize the system, so we should end up with a big F. So let's first look at what big F is. Let's do race exception before. So what we want big F to be is the discretized system dynamics. So we have a mapping going from states and controls and integration interval to the state at the end of that integration interval. Why do we make the integration interval an argument here? It's because we want to do time optimal control to make it a bit more challenging. So how could we do time optimal control? We pick a mechanism to construct the nonlinear program in CasADi. I use here IPOPT because it's easier to make demonstrations with, but you can also use the more familiar NLP Sol if you like. So that's also perfectly possible. Let's do optimal control over a specific horizon of 20 intervals, and let's initialize the time optimal value with 10. So in fact, what we do is first declare the time as a decision variable with an initial guess. And then we declare variables for all the states over all the control intervals. So we'll do multiple shooting. Then the controls are also decision variables. Then with our bicycle model, we will do some obstacle avoidance. I didn't prepare any plots, so we'll just have to look at the mathematics here. Sorry about that. We can also make the problem parametric just for fun. So we can declare x0 to be a parameter of the problem. And that will be handy to later on set an initial constraint. So we can constrain the first state to be this x0 parameter. And then you can imagine once you construct the problem, you can just update the parameter and very quickly get an optimal result for a different initial state. And that's basically what MPC is, model predictive control. Before we can do that, just let's construct the problem further. So we have declared variables and parameters. Now we need to declare constraints. So in a loop, we will do the multiple shooting or the gap closing constraint. So we say that the state at interval k plus 1 is equal to the prediction of our model based on the state of interval k and the control of interval k. We have initial constraints. As I just said, we have path constraints and we have obstacle avoidance, which is also path constraint. Final constraint, why not? To make a variation, I didn't constrain all of states. So I only picked the first two, which is the position. So the arrival angle is free, or the arrival orientation is free, so to speak. This is for initial values. Then we do the objective. I chose here to just lump the whole list of x together and then use the CasADi operation to say we slice the first row of the big X, which means the x positions. We do the sum of square of those and add together with the time. So it's time optimal plus a bit of regularization. Also here I won't go in details. Let's start with IPOPT first. That's quite slow. I don't know. Okay, maybe because I'm recording. It's because of the function evaluation. So the first thing to try is always, not always, but often you can with expand. Get some speed up already. So the timings on the slide I did with a different computer, so they're not gonna map identically to this computer. All right, so this is IPOPT. The slow solver, let's try with Fatrop. So we just drop, remove IPOPT and just type Fatrop. And the thing is, this will just work out of the box, but this will not have detected the structure yet. So it will consider the whole constrained Jacobian as one dense block and basically do optimal control with zero control intervals. So this is typically not what you want. So I'm going to suggest to CasADi to use the automatic structure detection and also set the debug option. That's quite handy. Let's run this and you get, you're blasted with errors about the structure detection. You can also do manual structure. You can supply the structure manually, but I won't explain that here. Let's debug what the problem is with the structure. So there's a handy debugging script that you can fetch here from this link. I already downloaded it. Let's run this. This is structure. So if you look at all the actual sparsities here, so here, here, there, you see it looks nothing like the structure I have here. So typically your CasADi problem will need a little bit of manipulation to get into the exact structure that is needed for Fatrop. So let's just try that, or let's look at the graph first. On the columns, you have the different optimization variables. On the rows, you have the different constraints. So this is the constraint Jacobian view. And you'll notice that all of these, we have chosen here to first do variables for all states and then for all constraints. So they're kind of separated, and that's why you get this double banded thing. So that's not what we want. We want to kind of interleave these and first have x0, u0, x1, u1, etc. So let's do some manipulation. And yeah, it will really depend on how you coded your problem, how you should do that for your application. Let's try this. Let's try the suggestion here. Yeah, that makes sense. So we do a loop where we interleave the X and the U generation. We should not forget that in the end, we also have, we need to append X again because we want X plus, okay, N plus one variables for the states. Okay, let's run the before script again. Sadly, we're not there yet, so let's look at the debug view again. And this is starting to look something like something, so it's more diagonally bound and there's some detection going on. You see the first interval is completely okay, so that was corrected okay. It identified there are three states. 3x3 is the linearized A matrix, you have a B matrix, constraints, that looks more or less okay, but the rest is still wrong. And in fact, the script tries to highlight where there are problems with these lines. It's not ideal yet, but it could be helpful for you. The main problem here is this first column. So we have a dense-ish column here. So every state, every dynamic constraint or gap closing constraint apparently depends on the first variable. And that is normal because that is the time. So what we should do to get this block diagonal structure is lift these or introduce extra variables for time and then match them. So that's what I'll do next. Let's say T is not a single thing. No, it's going to be a vector or a list of variables, just like we had for state. And then, yeah, like this, the initial thing we drop, this we also drop. Now what we change is that we call the discretized dynamics, not with this general T over N, but with the local TK over N. Let's not forget to do the initial values. So let's do Let's do this and this also. And now we still have one task. Now we have many T variables and they all have to be matched. So it is some kind of gap closing, in fact. Like mathematically, it's indistinguishable from the dynamic constraints, like this. One more change we have to do is in the objective. So we cannot just add T because T is now a list. So let's fix that. Let's say, let's make T into one big MX vector and then ask CasADi to do the sum of that. Hopefully this suffices. Let's run the script. Yes, it worked. So we're not quite down to the 4 milliseconds yet because we didn't do the co-chain. Let's first look at the Fatrop worked. Let's look at the debug view again. There's no offending rows this time, so no horizontal lines, but we can have a look here. So as you can see, Fatrop will have these red, blue, green, and yellow blocks considered dense. Our actual problem is much sparser. So in this green block, we have space to have 12 numbers, but only two of them are actually used. So it's a loss of sparsity when going through to Fatrop. But the linear algebra for small matrices is really optimized in modern processors, thanks to the Blasfeo library. So Blasfeo is developed by Freiburg Group. It's also very nice software by Gianluca. So this is really fast linear algebra, and this is what is used under the hood by Fatrop to exploit this. So this is basically it. Let's do one more thing before we close, and we add the code generation. So in this case, I set jitting equal to true, so just in time compilation, and then I have some extra thing for a cached version of GCC, some compilation flags. Depends a bit. Again, it's not the same computer as I had for the other timings, but the function evaluation got faster and the total time is a lot less than what we started from. And the iterations are still the same. All right, let's conclude with some remarks here. So as I said, CasADi will be shipping with Fatrop and its interface. From next release onwards. You can already, if you check this video now before 3.6.6 is released, you can already go to the nightly builds and just pip install one of these. Let me know if there's any problems with interface. Naturally, it will also be available in MATLAB, like anything in CasADi. Fatrop interface is compatible with CasADi CodeGen, so that's nice. And if you got excited about this new solver and using CasADi, I can really recommend the hands-on course in November, which will be given by me in a physical course in Belgium. And there we will get up to speed with CasADi syntax, best practices, and really the mathematics behind this formulation, that this becomes your second nature. If you're already a CasADi expert or just interested in the solver, you can also help spread the word on the CasADi course by printing and hanging up a flyer somewhere in your department. And if you do that and give a proof here on this link, you can contend in a contest to win a VR headset. So that's it for this demonstration. I hope you're really excited about this new solver, Fatrop, from my colleague Lander. And let me know what you think.